Hello, Brutally Delicious. I'm Anthony Alfaro, also known as Tony of Tony and the Kiki, and I'm here to answer some of your questions.
What is your earliest musical memory?
It's probably my dad. My dad was a DJ, right, in the 80s before I was born. And he would then subsequently DJ all my parents' parties or all our family parties. So I remember my parents used to throw this like awesome Halloween party for them and their friends. And yeah, my dad would DJ, and I just remember, and like we weren't allowed at these parties, these were like adult only parties, but I remember them setting up, you know, changing the lights out in the ceiling, like they put like purple and red lights and cobwebs and skeletons and all that stuff. And yeah, I just remember him warming up and just it being so loud and funky, and he used to play like everything, you know, everything from Zeppelin to Grandmaster Flash to Patti LaBelle, you know what I mean? Michael Jackson, just everything. So yeah, that's probably what I remember, if I were to pick one.
Did you play an instrument in school?
I did not, but I was a part of the choir, Catholic school. Very pure Catholic school choir vibes, yes.
Were you exposed to music by your family as a child?
Yes, obviously my dad, right, DJ. But then my mom is like a real life disco queen. Like in the 70s, 80s, she was at the club, she was at Studio 54, she was twirling, she was at basement parties, she was learning salsa, you know, she was learning how to hustle, and like she is an incredible dancer, this woman. But yeah, so that's like a part of her identity. So I always think about it like the two cars, right? Like in my dad's car, it was hip hop, R&B, rap, and like classic rock. And then in my mom's car, it was like disco, giving you Donna Summer, Sylvester, Latin music, Celia Cruz, you know, Queen of Salsa, Gloria Estefan, Marc Anthony, all them. And then, show tunes. Like she loves Barbara Streisand, who I also love. But yeah, so, and then, you know, so my dad, it's like Mary J. Blige, Lauryn Hill, Biggie, Boyz II Men was huge. Faith Evans. So.
What was the first concert you ever attended?
And my first concert I ever attended was the Metallica St. Anger Tour at Nassau Coliseum. I remember it was seventh grade, because seventh grade is when we get our confirmation in Catholic school, right? And the night of the Metallica concert was the night of the rehearsal for the confirmation. And in order to go to the confirmation, you have to go to the rehearsal. It's non-negotiable. So it was a very easy, like, well, I won't get confirmed this year because I have to go to the Metallica concert. And of course, my mother and my grandmothers are like, ay, diablo, you know, the devil. But, you know, we worked it out. My uncle Mike, my godfather, who was taking me to the concert, who was a metalhead, you know, total rocker, picked me up outside of the church. I mean, the second I was done, I jetted out of there, ripped off whatever Catholic school uniform I had on, and, you know, under it was like a Metallica t-shirt. And, you know, I of course bought at Hot Topic. Where else? Iconic. And we got there like right before they started playing, or maybe like right as they had started. And yeah, I can still like feel it. You know, I can't necessarily remember everything about it, but I can still feel it. Like I can feel how the stadium shook, and I can still see the people screaming, and just like, I can see the stage and just them running around the, you know, not even running, more so like prowling around the stage. And it was just like, you know, and I was a really nerdy, chubby loser, you know? Not a loser, but you know what I mean? Like, and to see that was just so invigorating and liberating and, you know, oh, it was incredible.
What was the first record you ever bought with your own money?
First record I ever bought with my own money was definitely a Spice Girls record. I'm pretty sure it was Spice World, their second studio album. I mean, this is a controversial statement, but the Spice Girls were my Beatles. You know, I'm a child of the 90s. They were my British invasion. I was obsessed. I had the posters. I had the lollipops. I had the dolls. I had the t-shirts. I had the anything there was. That's what I wanted for Christmas, my birthday. That's what I spent my piggy bank money on, obviously. So, you know, when this album came out, I think it had already been out. I just didn't own it. I saved up my coins. We went to FYE or Borders or wherever it was that we got our CDs back in the 90s, and I bought that mother and I played it out, okay? Played it out.
How much of a role has music played in your life?
I think it's pretty clear. Huge role. You know, it's what I do. Professionally, it's my identity. And it's something that was instilled in me, you know, by my family, by my surroundings. Music is my everything. It's the one constant.
Do you have a favorite genre of music you like to listen to?
You can kind of see now my influences are pretty eclectic, right? But I would say favorite genres, it's a tie between like good old classic rock of the 60s and 70s, some of the 80s, not all of it. And then like classic soul, you know, 60s, 70s, Aretha Franklin, Al Green, Donny Hathaway, Patti LaBelle. The best singers to ever live, right? And then disco. You know, I'm definitely my mother's son that way. I do love disco. Donna Summer, I mean, it's everything. So I would say it's those genres are my fave. But then also, you know, I love vintage music. I sing in a rock band, but like, don't get it twisted. I love a top 40 bop. I love a Dua Lipa moment. I love a Megan Thee Stallion moment. You know, I love Lizzo. I'm not one of those rockers that's gonna be like, the top 40. No, sometimes I get down. And yeah, good music is good music.
Do you have a favorite musical artist you like to listen to?
The first thing that comes to mind is Fleetwood Mac. I mean, so many songs, so many records, so much vibe, so much warmth, so much magic, beautiful vocals, beautiful harmonies, obviously bass, drums, guitar, fucking fabulous record production. So them, and then also Chaka Khan is just like Chaka fucking Khan. Chaka Khan with Rufus, Chaka Khan with Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan with anybody. I mean, like, the voice is, it's one of my favorite voices of all time. And just the groove of the music that she makes is just, and a lot of it is just so uplifting and invigorating and empowering. So Chaka Khan and Fleetwood Mac.
Do you have a song you would like played at your funeral?
Another One Bites the Dust by Queen. No, I'm just kidding. But I would want something upbeat. You know, it's already going to be a very sad day, okay? No, I'm just kidding. No, not really. But if I had to say, it's also kind of silly, but the first thing I thought of, Last Dance by Donna Summer. Last dance tonight. Ba-da-da, ba-da-da, ba-da-da. And then the last chance for love. I'm getting lowered into the ground with the disco ball. I mean, well, actually, I want to be cremated, so disco ball at the crematorium. And that's the last question, so I'll leave it there. Thanks, guys. Also, follow us, Tony and the Kiki, TonyandTheKiki, on TikTok, on Instagram. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. And check us out wherever you listen to music. We have two singles out right now, Light It Up and Extra Express. And we have our debut EP, Light It Up, coming out November 16th. So stay tuned. Thanks for listening to me talk about music.